it's Glenn here. We're going to do some mods on our Dromida KODO. Thing flies really nicely, except that I found that when it crashes, sometimes the propellers smash into the wall, and we don't want that to happen, as well as the chassis sometimes hits the ground because there's a space between the chassis and the bottom of the legs. So we're going to make a couple modifications so that when you do crash the thing, it might last a little longer. Okay, let's go check out the work table now. All right, so the problem with the KODO is that when we're flying, sometimes the thing hits the wall. So if this is the wall, either it goes up or it goes down. If it goes down, the propellers are hitting the ceiling. Okay, so what we've done is we've made a stay for it. Okay, it's made out of a paper clip. Okay, and I'm going to show you how that works. Now, of course, we're worried about weight. So that little piece of paper clip actually only weighs 0.5 gram. Okay, so now we're going to show you how we install it. Okay, what you're going to need to do the project is you're going to need 4 lightweight paper clips, metal ones. You can use lighter weight ones than this. That's all I had. You need some of this goop. It's called goop, and it's super strong type of glue. And you'll need a pair of needle nose pliers. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead and we're going to straighten out the paper clip first. So what we're going to do is open the paper clip and slowly take the flat part and get it straight. You don't want to bend it, you just want to straighten it because these things have little serrations. Okay, so once you've got your piece of steel straight, you measure across. There's two little notches on the outside here. Okay, so you take a tiny little bend, just the end of the point of the needle nose, make a little bend in it like that. So it actually has an inside angle, so it'll hook onto this here. Then what you do is you measure over to a little bit further than you actually need, over to about here. So measure this over to about here and make your cut. Okay, then what you do is you make look down there so that they're in the same plane, and you get your needle nose pliers again. Make another little bend, so it's again, it's sort of pointed in. Okay, now straighten this thing out a little bit. Make sure it's nice and straight. Okay, and then you hook it over one end, and then we're going to hook it over the other end. Now what that does is it gives you a higher profile so that there's actually something above this before your propeller hits, as well as it makes like a triangulation so that if you're holding this, it actually won't go down as much, and it'll give you a little more room there. So that's what we do with making a little stays for it. I weighed it all out. It's only a couple of grams. The thing is able to lift no problem. We're going to glue the ends here. And now the other modification, which I recommend, is because the chassis, basically when it hits the ground, it hits the ground to such force that the chassis actually can hit the ground, or these outside stays can break. So what we want to do is we want to reduce the clearance from the ground to the bottom of the chassis. So what I've done is I've used already 2 blobs of this shoe goo, and I've built it up a little bit, and then I put a couple of dabs on each end of the feet. So now when it comes down, it's actually on a little bit of a rubbery stance, so it doesn't hit in such a hard right onto the hard plastic, as well as there's less clearance, so the chassis will have it won't smack all the way down onto the cement. When it lands hard, it'll land right on the bumper a little more, and so since this is a softer kind of rubber compound, it'll actually give you a little bit more give. So I think those modifications will make your
Kodo last a little longer. It's a lot of fun, and I suggest adding these to your machine and making the thing last a little longer. All right, thanks for watching. Bye.
Okay, so this is the all of them installed.